At this time, for your listening pleasure, I'm going to turn the mic over to my co-host for the weekend, the lovely Miss Christy Meyer.
Honorable judges, this is your class. Exhibitors, you're being judged at the Fino. Paso Fino, por favor.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is your Classic Fino Sub-Junior Youth. This is the future of our breed, so this class in particular is extremely important, and we are very excited to have all these youngsters showing.
Hold, please hold. Let's proceed at the Fino. Paso Fino, por favor.
These youth riders are ages 7 through 12, so they are on the younger side. And they are being currently judged on 65% in Classic Fino, 15% appearance, conformation, and way of going, along with 10% of manners, and rounding it out with 10% on the sounding board.
Exhibitors, let's try to space your horses when you can, please. Reverse, please. Reverse.
For those of you who have never had the opportunity to actually ride a Classic Fino horse, we have a saying in training, anybody can go fast. The really talented riders can go slow.
Hold, please, hold. Proceed at the Fino. Paso Fino, por favor.
Horses in the Classic Fino division must work in both directions, and they're called for reverses and halts. Once that halt is over, they are to proceed directly into gate.
Reverse, please, reverse. Hold, please. Let's proceed at the fino. Paso fino, por favor.
The amount of comprehensive and understanding.
Beginning with 384, let's have you take the sounding board in both directions. Okay, we'll do 458, then 384 will be next.
As the judge is walking through and checking headgear, I do want to remind everybody in the audience that the performance of the horse on the sounding board shall not be given preference over the horse's rail work. It only accounts for 10% of the entire class. And again, Classic Fino is 65% of this class.
Paul Marlowe, see the announcer. Paul Marlowe, see the announcer. Ladies and gentlemen, we now have the official result. So class number 253, the Classic Fino Sub-Junior Youth. Once again, let's put our hands together and give all these sub-juniors a nice round of applause, please. Fifth place. It's awarded to exhibitor 458, Madison Cambon, writing Victoria the All-Star. Jose Rodriguez, Miami, Florida, the owner. Fourth place, awarded to 512, Camila Gabotti, writing Vanidosa de Guadalupe. And Camila Gabotti, Miami, the owner. Third place, it's awarded to 635, Christine Sotolongo, writing Capricho de la Botija. Osvaldo Sotolongo, Miami, the owner. Now, ladies and gentlemen, second place, awarded to 567, Daniela Nario, writing Sonero de la Ilusión. José Rodríguez and Lázaro Nario, Miami, the owners. And your first place, Blue Ribbon, 384, Angelina González, writing Salomé de Lusitania. Hacienda Villazar, Miami, Florida, the owners. Congratulations.
Oh, later.